I could be center stage. Taking the big parts. I'm not interested in being worthy. I'm not interested in being virtuous and standing there for the good of the company. I'm simply not interested in that. I say, bollocks.
In 1991, in The Silence of the Lambs by Jonathan Demme, Anthony Hopkins achieves worldwide success playing a cannibalistic psychopath imprisoned in a cage, the most famous serial killer of all time, Hannibal Lecter. Even though he was on screen for only 20 minutes throughout the movie, it's enough to propel him to the top of Hollywood at almost 60 years old and after more than 30 years of acting. The biggest directors fight over him, like Francis Ford Coppola, who casts him in Dracula.
Asher! Mina!
Bear! Even Steven Spielberg wants him to play the President of the United States in Amistad.
And you're coming down to your secretary. This is something in Providence. Yeah. But this is a better location, so we'll do that first. Have you seen the House of Representatives?
No.
Come here. You're going to love this.
1992 is a turning point for him. In addition to becoming the favorite actor of James Ivory, it's also the year that he is cemented among the greatest actors of all time for his iconic role in The Silence of the Lambs.
And the Oscar goes to Anthony Hopkins in The Silence of the Lambs.
And then I thought when I got up there to take the Oscar, I thought, well, now I can do some bad films, which I proceeded to do. It doesn't matter, really. I touched the ceiling of my life, I suppose.
I love the coldness of life. I love the inevitability of it all.